Hey folks, Jeff here at Back to Country. If you remember a few weeks back, well actually it's probably a month or so ago, we found some bees in one of our pieces of equipment. We basically got them out of there and eventually got them into a hive. Here's that hive here. And today we're gonna go in and inspect it, see how they're doing, and just take a look and see where we go from here. Hopefully everything's doing good, because there are bees coming in and out of the hive, so we know they're in there. So first thing we're going to do, apply a little smoke. That kind of just calms the bees. Some say that the introduction of smoke makes the bees think that there's a forest fire or something, and that causes them to concentrate on, oh my god, do we need to evacuate, what do we need to do, and focusing on maybe even gorging themselves with honey, so that in case they have to leave the hive, that they can take supplies with them in their, every bee has a little honey stomach, allows them to carry some. These bees are really gentle, I think, anyway. Of course, we've never invaded their hive, but when I kicked them out of their last hive location, they were definitely gentle. I never had one even attempt to sting me. None of them crashed into my hood or anything telling me to get out of here. They were all really calm and just focusing on getting out of their hive, because they didn't like what I was putting in there, which was a product called Honey Robber. And that's just a chemical called butyric that smells like vomit, to be honest, and they don't like it, and it definitely causes them to leave. Okay, so we got the top cover off, and here's the inner top cover, or inner cover. We'll take a look at that, and I can see bees in there, so that's good. They've glued that top down with propolis. You hear it popping free. I can definitely feel that propolis holding it. Give them a little more smoke to let them know we're here. Move this back. Okay, let's see what they've been doing. Hopefully they've had enough resources. I've noticed a lot of horse mint growing around here. There's some right here by the hive even. And that provides a great source of nectar, so hopefully they use that to really build up the hive.
And it's okay, look.
Oh, look, there's a piece of comb that they built to the top cover. They found a empty spot. I guess I didn't do quite a good job of getting those spaced right. It happens. Sometimes you get in a hurry and do things like that, but it's all right. The important thing is the bees are here and they're building a hive. Our intent this year is really nothing more than to get a healthy hive. Now you can see there's a little bit of wax on here, but they really haven't built anything. Same thing on the other side. There's some wax, but that's about it. That's all right. And here's another one that it's missing a insert, but no big deal. They haven't done nothing with it. Oh, when we pulled that other one out, we actually broke a piece of, they had built that sucker all the way to the ground. I don't like that at all. That's not good. But now here's some that they actually are building right. And this is what we want to see. Now these are foundationless frames. There's a little ridge here that they build on. And you can see the comb that they've built here. That's all natural comb. And you see a bunch of it capped there. That's brood. And you can see inside, I can see larvae in there. Looking pretty good, actually. I can't flip it over because they haven't tied it to the bottom yet, but overall, what I see looks good. And again, the bees, they're not attacking me at all. I mean, I haven't had one attempt to sting me. I haven't had one bounce off of me. That's just how I like them. Here's another one that they built out real nice. Again, the queen's laying good in there. Do lots of capped brood and some larvae, some mixed honey. This is a good looking frame there. Unfortunately, this piece that they built down the middle has got a bunch of, mostly it looks like some, oh, that wasn't good. Well, there's one way to actually make them mad. They'll clean that up later and remove that nectar from it. But unfortunately, there's some brood in there too. Another good looking frame. You know, sometimes you hate doing these inspections because you're disturbing the bees at work and you hate the idea of things like that happening. But unfortunately, they were building outside of a frame, so it really needed to come out anyway. But it's just the way it goes. Thought I got a glimpse of the queen sneaking around down there, but she's too quick. I see a couple of little small hive beetles in there. Those are a pest. And see that? That's a small hive beetle there. Oop, he just flew away. Bummer. Otherwise, I was going to kill him, but it's the way it goes. Honey right there. Just a little bit of honey in that, but normally I would not put a second brood box on this early because I would normally wait until that first hive is full 80%, but because I don't live here and I'm not going to be back for I don't know how long, I go ahead and I'm going to put that on there, and then I'm going to feed them so that that's going to help them resource wise so they can get that hive built. And this is just what's called an entrance feeder. just like that, we've got the hive closed up. I'm gonna leave this wax here. They may do something with it, meaning they might chew on it and reuse it, or they might just leave it. But this is what I'm gonna turn around. It's got honey in it, so I turn it around so they can get to the side with honey, and they'll extract that honey from there and take it into the hive and definitely not let it go to waste. So pretty simple process. I just wanted to get in there quick